Welcome to A Plus Health Life Channel. We discuss the ways to fulfill your life with more quality and inform you on ways to get to your life goals with less effort. Please do not forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Scarsdale Diet Ultimate Guide for Weight Loss. The Scarsdale Diet is a fad diet that was designed in the 1970s for weight loss. Originally published in Herman Tarnauer's book, The Complete Scarsdale Diet, the diet has since been determined to carry health risks and is not considered one that is particularly good or of nutritional value to follow. A diet of the 1970s. Developed by cardiologist Herman Tarnauer, the Scarsdale diet was similar to the Atkins diet in that it encouraged a high-protein and low-fat diet that emphasized fruits and vegetables. Those following the diet outside of all of the news surrounding Herman Tarnauer were fashion elites and society women who were looking for a quick weight loss program. However, it was soon discovered that the diet's fat ratio was believed to actually increase the risk of heart disease, and while followers of the fad diet saw some results early on, their weight loss was not sustained. A high-protein, low-calorie diet. The Scarsdale diet works by following a very restricted eating plan. Only 1,000 calories are allowed per day, no matter one's activity level, gender, or body size. Additionally, no substitutions or variations are allowed. Each meal for breakfast, lunch, and dinner is specifically created for each of the days of the two-week diet. Three meals are eaten per day, and snacks aren't allowed with the exception of carrots and celery. This high-protein program also tells followers to consume quite a bit of fruit and vegetables over the two-week period. Each day, the calorie consumption is designed to be broken down as such. 43% of calories from protein. 22.5% of calories from fat. 34.5% of calories from carbs. Compliant foods that one could eat while on the Scarsdale diet include cheese, eggs, nuts, fruit, poultry, seafood, black coffee, tea, water, diet soda, bread, leafy greens. A highly criticized diet. Experts came out saying that the diet prohibits nutrient-dense foods, which can put individuals at risk for a variety of different nutrient deficiencies. Further, the diet restricts calories to a level that can be unsustainable for some, especially if they are more athletic or naturally need a higher calorie intake to support their bodies. A pop culture phenomenon. The real popularity behind the Scarsdale diet comes down to the unfortunate and untimely death of its creator, Herman Tarnauer. Eventually, the popularity of the book, movie, and diet ended up fading off, particularly after reports of the increased risk of heart disease and lack of weight loss started to circulate. A calorie-restrictive diet, the Scarsdale diet is one of many fad diets that don't quite hold up when examined by experts. Though it remained popular for some time due to the murder of Herman Tarnauer, it has slowly become more of a relic of decades and diet trends gone by than a popular diet in today's world. According to reports, Dr. Tarnauer wrote out his weight loss program as a two-page plan that he handed to patients who needed to slim down for improved heart health. The program was often copied and handed out to others, and the plan gained popularity through word of mouth. Hoping to capitalize on the success of the Atkins diet, Tarnauer turned the diet plan into a book. The very low calorie intake and extreme weight loss promises have been heavily criticized by health experts. However, movies and other television programs based on Tarnauer's life and the scandal surrounding his murder continue to gain attention. How it works. The Scarsdale diet is a very strict eating plan that allows for just 1,000 calories per day, regardless of your body size, gender, or activity level. No substitutions of any kind are allowed, and each meal is specifically defined for each of the 14 days of the diet. On the plan, you eat three meals per day. Snacks are not allowed except for carrots and celery. This is a high-protein program that also includes fruits and vegetables. You consume 43% of your calories from protein, 22.5% of calories from fat, and 34.5% of your calories from carbohydrates. Limited vegetables. Some vegetables, including leafy green vegetables, zucchini, green beans, and Brussels sprouts are usually part of the day's diet, generally at dinner. Carrots and celery are the only snacks allowed on the plan. Cheese and eggs. Eggs are included in a few lunch menus and can be prepared according to your preference as long as no fat is used. Cheese slices and cottage cheese are also included in a few lunch menus. Nuts. Nuts are not included in the standard meal plan. However, on the substitute lunch plan, you are allowed to have 6 halves of walnuts or pecans. Fruit. Grapefruit is included in every breakfast. It is also included in several lunches. Fruit salad is also included in a lunch menu. Meat, poultry, seafood. Roast chicken and turkey, lamb, hamburger, and broiled steak are included in dinner menus. Fish and shellfish are also on a dinner menu. Cold cuts are included in lunch menus, although fatty meats such as bologna are not allowed. Zero-calorie beverages. Black coffee, tea, water, and diet soda are included in the plan. Cream and sugar in your tea or coffee are not allowed. Protein bread. Protein bread, made with soy flour, whole wheat flour, and gluten flour, is a staple on this plan. A recipe is provided in the book, but this product was also available in grocery stores in the 1970s. Alcoholic beverages. No alcohol is allowed during the 14-day Scarsdale diet. However, on the maintenance plan, 1 serving of dry alcohol is allowed per day. Butter and other spreads. No added fat is allowed on the program, including butter, margarine, salad dressings, peanut butter, olive oil, or avocado. Potatoes, rice, sweet potatoes, beans. Starchy vegetables and legumes are not allowed on the plan as they are significant sources of carbohydrate. Sugary treats. No desserts of any kind, ice cream, baked goods, candy, etc. are allowed on the program. On some days, fruit may be consumed. Pasta and flour-based foods. No bread or pasta products are consumed on the diet, except for specific amounts of protein bread. Full-fat milk. Only low-fat and non-fat milk products are allowed. During this phase, you follow a similar but slightly more relaxed version of the Scarsdale diet. For example, in the maintenance phase, you can have 1 alcoholic drink per day. The maintenance plan can be followed indefinitely until you see your weight creep up. If you start to gain weight, as defined as a 4-pound weight increase on the scale, you are advised to go back on the 14-day Scarsdale diet. Resources and tips. Most people who followed the Scarsdale diet did so by purchasing the book. The program was available in both paperback and hardcover editions, although paperback versions were more popular. At the time that this diet was released, the internet did not exist. However, since the book has gone out of print and technology has evolved, several websites are now dedicated to the program. These sites outline the 14-day meal program and some provide recipes for the protein bread. None of these sites are affiliated with the original program. Modifications. Scarsdale diet is designed for adult men and women in normal health. He states that those with medical problems and pregnant women should not use the plan without the approval of a physician. The book provides 2 modified versions of the diet, a vegetarian plan and an international plan. The vegetarian plan recommends the same caloric intake, but the meal plans are based on vegetables, fruits, some dairy products, nuts, and limited amounts of grains. Some vegetables, such as sweet potatoes, are not allowed. The international plan is a diet plan that allows for more variety. Each day is assigned a specific cuisine, i.e. Monday is American Day, Tuesday is Japanese Day, Wednesday is French Day, etc. However, the calorie and macronutrient intake are the same and the eating rules don't change. Pros. Simple. The Scarsdale diet is easy to follow and leaves very little room for error. Each meal is outlined and includes only 2 to 3 foods. Substitutions are strongly discouraged. Dr. Tarnauer explains that if you have a food allergy, substitutions are all right, but otherwise, foods should be consumed exactly as indicated. Specific meal plan provided. Consumers who don't like having to plan meals or count calories liked this program because all the work is done for you. There is not a lot of variation from meal to meal, so shopping should be simple, and most foods, except for the protein bread, are easily found in most markets. Inexpensive. Compared to weight loss programs that require you to buy prepackaged food, this program is likely to be less expensive. Food is consumed in very small quantities, so your grocery bill for the 2 weeks of the plan is not likely to be high. No subscription or long-term commitment. Unlike many weight loss programs that are popular today, there is no subscription required to follow the Scarsdale diet. Consumers can simply buy the book, if they can find an available copy, or get one from the library to follow the plan. However, even though the ease of this plan makes it appealing, there are substantial drawbacks that you should consider before going on this diet. Cons. Extremely low in calories. Everyone who follows the Scarsdale diet consumes 1,000 calories per day, regardless of age, body size, activity level, or gender. As a basis for comparison, most weight loss programs today set a minimum calorie target of roughly 2,000 to 1,500 calories for women and 1,600 to 1,800 calories for men. Those who are very active generally consume more calories. Many health sources recommend that very low-calorie diets such as this should only be followed under the guidance of a healthcare professional. Point 1. Not sustainable. While some people may be able to follow this program for 2 weeks, many people will find that the program is too restrictive to maintain. Researchers have recommended that diets should be nutritionally adequate and tailored to meet individual needs in order to be sustainable for the long term. Additionally, those who live active, healthy lifestyles may struggle to maintain their physical activity level on just 1,000 calories per day. You may feel lethargic, experience headaches, and have an overall decrease in motivation if you don't consume enough fuel each day. Limits healthy carbohydrates. During the 2 weeks that you follow the Scarsdale diet, your carbohydrate intake is substantially limited. While you will still consume healthy greens such as spinach and green beans, your intake of healthy fiber-rich foods like legumes and whole grains is severely restricted. Unrealistic weight expectations. A desired weight chart is provided in the book that readers can use as a guideline to see if they should lose weight. The chart does not take any factors other than gender into account, and according to Dr. Tarnauer is based on his years of medical experience. By today's standards, the weights provided may seem restrictive. For example, a 5 feet 4 inches woman should weigh between 110 and 123 pounds, which is on the lower end of the current healthy BMI recommendation. A man who is 5 feet 11 inches should weigh between 152 and 168 pounds. There is no discussion of lean muscle mass or body composition. Overpromises weight loss. The cornerstone of the Scarsdale diet's popularity was its promise of quick weight loss. According to the book's claims, you can lose 20 pounds in 14 days when you follow the plan. Current health recommendations advise that a safe and healthy rate of weight loss is 1 to 2 pounds per week. Additionally, the weight lost on this plan is likely to be primarily water weight as a result of carbohydrate restriction. May result in nutrient deficiencies. If calories and healthy carbohydrates are limited, it is possible that those following this eating pattern will not meet the recommended daily allowance for vital nutrients. For example, without whole grains or legumes, it would be challenging to meet the RDA for fiber. Those following the Scarsdale diet would need to choose foods very carefully to get their recommended intakes, making this program harder to follow, which eliminates one of the most appealing aspects of the diet. How it compares. When it was first released, the Scarsdale diet was most often compared to the Atkins diet. However, the Atkins program has changed substantially over the years and the programs are no longer comparable. Most likely due to the death of Dr. Tarnauer, the Scarsdale diet never evolved or adjusted to updated dietary guidelines provided by health experts. USDA recommendations. Food groups. The Scarsdale diet does not adhere to current guidelines provided by the USDA for protein, carbohydrate, or fat intake. According to the 2015-2020 dietary guidelines, adult men and women are advised to consume 10% to 35% of calories from protein, 45% to 65% of calories from carbohydrate, and 20% to 35% of calories from fat, with an emphasis on healthy fat. The USDA also provides a recommendation for dietary fiber, approximately 23 to 33 grams per day. On the Scarsdale diet, you consume 43% of your calories from protein, 22.5% of calories from fat, and 34.5% of your calories from carbohydrates. Fat intake comes primarily from saturated fat, and fiber intake is low. Calories. Current guidelines suggest that calorie intake should be personalized and take into account a person's age, activity level, gender, and body size. None of these factors are considered in the Scarsdale diet. The calorie target provided for the duration of the two-week program is substantially lower than what current guidelines would suggest. To get an estimate of your daily calorie needs, consider using a calorie calculator like the one below that takes into account personalized information to give you a healthy weight loss or weight maintenance goal. Similar diets. Atkins diet. The Scarsdale diet was widely compared to the Atkins diet when the program was first released. Both programs were developed by cardiologists in a medical setting and were provided to patients before being published in book form. While both programs started as low-carbohydrate, high-protein plans, the first iteration of Atkins allowed for more saturated fat than the Scarsdale diet. And Atkins followers consumed no fruit during the first phase, making it even lower in carbohydrates than Scarsdale. But the Atkins diet has since gone through many changes. The diet now includes three or four phases based on your current state of health and your goals. Atkins plans are personalized, to a certain extent, for different types of people. While the first phase of Atkins is similar to Scarsdale in its low-carb, high-protein approach, Atkins gradually includes more low-glycemic, high-fiber carbohydrates, including whole grains. Additionally, the Atkins plan, which is now available as a book or subscription meal delivery service, provides users with more lifestyle guidance, including an exercise program, cooking tips, and other support resources. The Scarsdale diet gained widespread popularity because the substantial weight loss claims it made were appealing to many people who were trying to slim down. While this specific diet is no longer popular, many other weight loss programs that make similar claims are widely promoted. It's important to critically evaluate any claims made a diet program or nutritional plan that you choose to undergo. In general, a healthy rate of weight loss is 1 to 2 pounds per week. Programs that promise much more than that may use methods that don't promote good nutrition or wellness. When in doubt, talk to your healthcare provider or speak to a registered dietitian to get personalized advice. Please do not forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel.